I am here in the Malacology collections of the Academy of Natural Sciences in Philadelphia. But what even is malacology? If you've ever collected and organized seashells on the beach, then you've dabbled as an amateur malacologist. Malacology is the study of mollusks. This includes animals like octopus, snails, slugs, and clams. It is the second largest phylum of animals, making them one of the most successful groups on the planet. There are over 80,000 described species of mollusks, with many more left to be discovered. Mollusca is composed of 8 recognized classes, including cephalopoda, gastropoda, polyplacophora, scaphopoda, monoplacophora, the aplacophorans caudofavia and solanogasters, and bivalvia. Mollusks have been important to humans for as long as we've existed, and I don't just mean as food. Mollusks have held cultural significance all over the world. Shell jewelry has been found at burial sites that are over 20,000 years old. Shells have even been used as currency throughout Asia, the Middle East, and Africa. Mollusks have even inspired art with legends like the Kraken, which turns out is based on the real-life giant squid. The first written work of malacology was Aristotle's book, Historia, Animalium. Yes, the same Aristotle that wrote about philosophy, art, and economics. That man did everything. In the Historia, Animalium, Aristotle detailed the anatomy, physiology, and ecology of many animals now considered to be mollusks. He set a standard for the future study of these animals. The collection and study of shells arose independently all over the world. In Japan, malacology became popular during the Edo period of the 17th century. The Edo period was a time of great peace following the wars of the Sengoku period. This left the warrior class of samurais with not much to do. These samurais turned to arts and natural history, including malacology, to fill their newfound leisure time. Many of the early European explorers doubled as naturalists, especially malacologists. As they traveled the globe, they would collect specimens and shells to bring back to their countries. This led to the creation of large global collections that could be used to study these animals. There are still many malacology collections around the world that are phenomenal tools in the study of mollusks and the concepts of evolution and ecology. That includes the Academy of Natural Sciences collection, which is the second largest catalog collection in the world. In these cabinets are 500,000 shell lots containing upwards of 10 million shells from all around the world. Data from this collection has been digitized and is now available for anyone to explore and use. It can be accessed through the Academy's collection website or at places like iDigBio. Thank you for watching. If you're interested in seeing more content related to mollusks or general biology, smash that like button and subscribe.
Smash that like button and subscribe.